What happens at puberty?
Dat is nou net een selletjie op beslag, né?
Ja.
Elke maand.
And this is what happens each and every month as from puberty, and this will last up till menopause when menstruation stops. And this diploid cell, as I've shown you, pointed out to you, undergo meiosis, and here it is, the reduction of the chromosome number, and we will find these cells after meiosis 1, they have half the number of chromosomes, which is haploid or 23 in each cell. You will also find that the one cell is smaller than the other one because the first polar body is formed, but the secondary oocyte will contain the ovum that will mature.
I remember last week we said that after meiosis, the product, end product of meiosis, is four haploid cells. In the case of sperm cells, four haploid sperm. But in oogenesis, we do not get four haploid cells at the end. We have one haploid egg cell, and the rest develop what would have been cells with the spermatogenesis, now develop into the polar bodies. Dit is net iets wat julle moet verstaan, hè? Daar's net een ovum. Al weet ons die produk van meiose is eintlik veronderstel om vier haploïde selle te wees. Een haploïde eiersel, die res polaire liggaampies.
En onthou, hulle is ook haploïd. Hulle is net nie, hulle bevat net nie die eiersel nie.
Hulle gaan nie bevrug word nie. Ja. Hulle is nie eintlik
wat hulle degenereer ook
maar. Ja, maar wat hulle doen is om deel te vorm van die membraan, hulle ondergaan mitose, om deel te vorm van die membraan wat die eiersel beskerm voor bevrugting. Right.
So now we have that meiosis 1 is completed, the reduction of the chromosome number is established, and this is what you see, the graafian follicle, that is the one in the ovary.